Not many people know what the habitat and way of life of olive ridley turtles, a rare species that lives in shallow waters. Olive ridley turtles are also one of the species protected by the Ministry of Maritime Affairs and Fisheries. The olive ridley turtle, Lepidocles olivacea, is a species of turtle that lives in shallow tropical and subtropical waters. Olive ridley turtles are usually found laying their eggs on the beaches of large bodies of water. The body shape of the olive ridley turtle has not changed from that of its ancestors 100 million years ago. This is proven based on fossil findings. Uniquely, these turtles have lighter skin than turtles, so they can move faster.
Kalau tukik kita lepas di pantai, di pasir itu dia positioning. Dia langsung positioning juga seperti kita mainan GPS. Nah, itu tujuannya, Pak. Kalau dia sudah benar-benar ingat tempat itu, dia akan mengarungi samudra, 20 tahun lagi dia kembali ke sini untuk bertelur. Ya. Jadi usianya 20 tahun.
In Indonesia, the olive ridley turtle is also called the gray turtle, the Bibi's turtle, the pseudo-hawksbill turtle, and the Slengkoro turtle. The olive ridley turtle is a species of the genus Lepidocles. Turtles in this genus are smaller in size than turtle species in other genera. SeaWorld states that the olive ridley turtle has a carapace length of around 51 to 75 centimeters. The weight ranges from 33 to 50 kilograms. Even though their size is small, the number of scutes, scales on the shell, of the olive ridley turtle is the highest among other turtles. Olive ridley turtles have 5 scutes in the middle, and 6 or more scutes on the sides. It is not surprising that the genus name, Lepidocles, means scaly in Greek.
Jadi ketika kita menetas itu harus kita lepaskan.
Harus segera.
Iya, harus segera dilepaskan. Kenapa? Karena untuk mengadaptasikan air. Tapi kita juga harus melihat polusi cahaya. Artinya kalau siang hari terlalu terik, dia tidak kuat matanya. Iya. Seperti itu. Jadi untuk kita melepaskan ya seperti ini, pagi kita mendapatkan yang menetas ya. Kita simpan dulu, sore nanti jam 5 itu baru kita rilis.
Olive ridley turtles have a global distribution. They inhabit tropical areas in the Indian, Pacific, and Atlantic oceans. These animals like to swim in the pelagic zone, but can also be found in coastal areas. Indonesia is also a habitat for olive ridley turtles. In one egg laying, the olive ridley turtle will produce 50 to 200 eggs. These eggs will then hatch 50 to 60 days later.
tapi kalau usianya, usia yang muda itu pertama bertelur paling hanya total telur 30-50 butir. Kalau yang 130 seperti ini kan sebenarnya 2 ya.
Ini sebenarnya kan 2. Ini dari satu sarang.
Dari satu sarang itu sampai 120 butir.
Oh,
iya. Tapi di sini kita pecah jadi 2 untuk pemerataan temperatur.
Biar suhunya iya. Pas.
Kalau temperatur kayak gini, yang temperatur tinggi menjadi betina. Temperatur rendah jadi jantan.
Compared to other turtle species, the olive ridley turtle has the largest number in the world. However, according to the IUCN, this species is experiencing a global population decline of 30-50%. Various human activities influence this condition. Olive ridley turtles often become victims of bycatch. This omnivorous animal is also often entangled in ghost nets, fishing nets that are no longer used and left in the ocean. Apart from that, busy ship traffic in the waters that are the habitat of the olive ridley turtle also has a negative impact on its existence. Coastal damage and climate change also threaten olive ridley turtles. As is known, female turtles usually lay their eggs on the beach where they hatch. If the beach where they are nesting is damaged or changes conditions, the reproductive activities of olive ridley turtles could be disrupted.
Dulu kita taunya penyu binatang yang dilindungi berdasarkan undang-undang, baik itu dari PBB maupun dari pemerintah RI sendiri. Tapi setelah kita pelajari, ternyata fungsi penyu itu ada dalam rantai makanan. Ya. Ini penyu kelihatannya lamban. Dia tugasnya utama, ini kalau kita ada infografis ini, ini tugasnya kebun, tukang kebun laut. Kenapa? Dia makan rumput laut, terus lamun, semacam ilalang yang ada di dasar laut. Jadi ini yang bisa mengganggu produksi plankton. Nah, oleh penyu itu dimakan. Sehingga plankton, mikroba, itu tumbuh bagus, berkembang. Ikan kecil makan, ikan besar, jadi predatornya ikan kecil, dan itu rantai makanan itu terjadi. Kita melestarikan penyu dengan cara mengedukasi masyarakat.
Turtles also play an important role in maintaining the balance of the deep sea ecosystem. They participate in the distribution of plankton and help maintain balance by eating various types of invertebrates. This role makes them pillars of the stability of the marine ecosystem and signifies the importance of each creature's role in the complex marine environment. The many threats to the existence of the olive ridley turtle could lead this species to extinction, if not treated seriously. Some practical things we can do to conserve olive ridley turtles is to keep the coastal environment clean. The process of hatching eggs on the beach and the baby turtle's first journey to the sea is a critical phase in their lives. Therefore, coastal preservation is crucial to support the survival of turtle species.